I'm for whatever's best for the nation. That's what I'm for. We got another joint we're about to check out together. Let me go ahead and pull this one up because people need to stop playing with Trump, bro. People keep on trying to act like Trump ain't the guy. Trump's still that guy. He is. And y'all know who Michael Rapaport is, right? He's the one who played the mailman. He played the mail. No, did he play the mailman? Yeah, he played the mailman on Next Friday. White comedian. He loved the Lakers. He don't like LeBron James. He loved Kobe. He loved Michael Jordan. Or do he like the New York Knicks? I think it's either the New York Knicks or the LA Lakers. He liked one of them. But he was pissed off at Trump for a really long time. And I want to show y'all this right here. I think it's absolutely hilarious. Y'all let me know whatever y'all want me to know in the comments. All right, let's get to it, man. And shout out to Patrick Bet David and the Valuetainment team over there.
Mm-hmm. One thing that I really disdain in the mainstream media, or even media in general, even with you guys, or when people are talking politics, is if the other side or a president you don't like does something good, it's never acknowledged. So I'm going to ask you this, because you could probably answer this better than me. What has the Biden administration done that you do like?
Yes. Also, I'm glad he asked him that. I'm glad he asked him that, because a lot of times if people are against the other side, they're not going to be willing to acknowledge anything that they love about the other side.
First of all, the economy is doing good. Mm-hmm. It's okay. Mm-hmm. Who is it good for, though? It's good for the rich guy. The people that are making money, they're doing good.
That's you.
Yeah, I mean, I'm okay. I'm not, again, like I said to Bill Maher, guys like me are going to be good no matter who's the president. By the way, the more they print money, I'm always going to make more money. Mm-hmm. Because money always rolls up to the wealthy, because the poor and middle income don't know how to keep it. They know how to spend it. The more they spend it, who do they spend it on? On capitalists that own equity. And the equity people make money. If I would say, you know, the fact that the expectation of a massive recession to be taking place, well, that didn't happen, because that could have been in shambles, mm-hmm. right? Unemployment stayed okay. I think Powell, the way he managed the interest rates while the way we were going about the economy was okay.
The interest rates they're not good right now.
It should stay like, and by the way, I said this last week.
They suck now, because I just bought a house and a car in the last, and the interest rates are like.
Where did you buy your house?
I don't want to say.
You're not going to like this.
But not in this state, and not in Texas, so I didn't get the, you know.
We have been teaching people how to grow online. It's been absolutely amazing. We have three people who have been able to reach monetization in less than 30 days. Growing YouTube channels, some from zero people. We have one guy who had 2 subscribers before he started working with me. He started helping him. His views went up 4.8%. We're super excited. If anybody ever want to grow on YouTube, you reach out to me with the word coach.
Okay. Yeah. So you're in New York or California?
Something like that.
I will say this to you on the interest rates. Even when Trump gets elected, my concern is he fires Powell and he brings somebody to lower the rates. If he lowered the rates immediately, we're going back to fake success again. And we need to filter out a little bit of the fake success. There's way too many people that made fake money that need to just quit. So here's kind of what happens. Guy goes and starts a business. He should have never started a business. He's a better guy working for a business owner because he doesn't have good habits. Because of his bad habits, he hurts the employees. He should get out of business and go work for the other guy that is a good operator. During fake success time, these people look like great operators.
Right.
But during economy like this, they get exposed and then they go and say, hey, man, can I work with you? No problem. Come on down. Because we need more solid operators, not fake success operators. We had a lot of those fake success operators during that 128-month economic expansion of pretty much zero interest rates. So, yeah, I'm not a fan of that.
Can I make a prediction?
Go ahead.
Brace for impact. You're going to vote for Trump. And I'll tell you why. Because you're...
I don't know if I could do
I'll
that.
I'll tell you why.
Mike, hang on.
And by the way, you're talking to somebody that was probably closer to your camp in 2016 and
he was anti-2020. This guy hated like
I never said hate. I didn't like Trump, but also I've never said the word hate. You can roll the tape.
Okay.
I didn't like a lot of things he did. A lot of things you highlighted. For me, there was the one that like I was like I can't do this was when he pretended like he didn't know who David Duke was. Everyone knows David Duke, leader of the KKK, is out there in Louisiana. Okay, come on, Trump. You don't know who this guy is. But you're also a reasonable person, and you're also a dude. Like, you're a dude. You like to play ball. You like hip-hop. You like to talk shit. You're not a woke LGBT unicorn type.
Beta. You're not beta.
That's not you.
No.
So you've seen what the left has produced over the last 4 years. Again, I'm telling you, somebody that's been in that camp, I'm a JFK Democrat. Mm-hmm. Why am I a JFK Democrat? Because my dad was a JFK Democrat.
He's just explaining to Michael Rapaport that, yo, you're logical. You're a logical being. And you make decisions based off of what makes sense. And this makes more sense than the side that you are over there kicking for. You know that. But you don't want to look a certain type of way. You don't want to be, you know, ostracized by your Hollywood friends for voting this way.
So that basically led to me being like, oh, JFK's the man. He's a Democrat. That led to me liking Clinton. I like Clinton. All right, cool. You know, he's out there kissing babies, you know, getting blowjobs. Charming. I like that guy. Charming guy.
Charming.
We met him recently. Start of a guy. His wife. Yeah, that's a whole nother conversation. But, you know, if you were looking at politics and you said you weren't paying attention to it, in my senior year, I worked at in Tallahassee, in Florida State, where I went to school, I worked at the Capitol building. Mm-hmm. This was during the 2000 election, Gore versus Bush. I was a Clinton guy. I was rooting for Gore, what have you. I used to see Jeb Bush, George W. Around this. Oh, shit. We saw what happened during the Bush administration, the bookends of it, 9/11, and then the great financial meltdown. There was no way in a million years that old John McCain was going to win the election over cool Barack Obama. It wasn't happening.
Yep.
So if you believe in the Obama doctrine, all right, you know, be nice to each other, whatever. There's no way you were voting for Trump. It just wasn't in the cards. It wasn't happening. It was abrasive. He was racist. The media, yada yada yada.
And he was a joke. Like New Yorkers, like he was like,
he's a ball busting troll.
Exactly.
He's a shit.
But here's why I think you're gonna vote for him this time, because you've seen what happened under his first term. You didn't like it. He's the pig. He's got the mean tweets and he's orange, but life was good. There was no wars. The economy was going good, but he's annoying to look at. But you also can acknowledge the media had a major role in that.
Listen, random reactions. Shout out to Random Reactions, guys. And if y'all haven't already started following Random Reactions, please go check out his channel. I'm guessing, he does reactions and they're random. These people aren't really pro-Trump. They're just pro-winning side, and Trump is winning. That's me. I'm not pro-winning side. I'm pro-country. I'm for whatever's best for the nation. That's what I'm for. That's it. I'm for what's best for the nation. And if that's being for the person who's winning, that's what I'm for. 1,000%. So if they are, hey, I'm with them.
A major role in that.
When you take a step back.
Yes. You also acknowledge that.
Because I will acknowledge that, you know, that one thing about the Charlottesville that I ranted about.
Yes.
And I was wrong.
About the both sides thing. Yes.
Yeah. And I respect
so irresponsible.
And I respect the shit out of it.
Wait, let me hear him out. Hang on. Yeah. Go a little bit more. What do you mean by that? You were wrong on that.
No, because he said the both sides, you know, there's good people on both sides. And when you see the full quote.
Yeah.
That wasn't what he said. You know, I ranted on him hard for that.
Mm-hmm.
Hard. There's some video about it, whatever. Yeah. I mean, I ranted hard because I was like, what are you talking about, man?
Because you got played. And here's what this is why I think you're going to vote for Trump. Is because you, much like me, much like many people, independent thinkers, not the sheep, realize we kind of got played a little bit. Yes, Trump ain't exactly the smoothest character. He's not
Jesus Christ.
No. But he actually, his policies and who he has around him are way better than what's going on there. And here's my final point.
Hey, thank you, David.
You see what's going on with the border. You see what's going on with the wokeness. You see what's going on with culture wars. And you see what's going on with actual wars.
Yeah.
Specifically, you see who the Democrats have exposed their hand, especially the progressive left. You see what's going on between Israel and Gaza. You have three starved David highs on your chest right now.
Mm-hmm.
And as someone who is a proud New Yorker your whole life, you see what the Democratic Party has turned into. This DEI-ESG woke manifestation of ridiculousness, intersectionality, decolonialization, you're looking at that and you say, you know what? As much as I can't stand big Donald Trump,
you said it.
At least he's normal. At least he doesn't want to turn my boy into
at least
a girl.
He's, well, at least he's normal. Well, yeah. Yes.
At least his politics. At least he doesn't want to turn my boy into a girl.
Yeah.
At least he's defending Israel, not the terrorists. And at the end of the day, I'm a reasonable person.
Yeah.
So like you said initially, I think I'm going to consider this.
Oh, I'm considering it.
Yes.
But to pull that, well, I don't know, we don't pull levers anymore.
Yeah.
Actually pull that lever.
Yeah, but pulling the lever for Biden.
And then
I'm going to tell you right now, I won't vote. I'm not voting for Biden.
No.
I'm not voting for Kamala. I'm not, you know.
But then
I'm
you
not,
can't talk shit. And you need to be able to talk shit.
Well, wait a minute. So you're saying, so for you.
I won't vote for them.
So no matter what, that decision is
final. That ain't
final.
Happening. Okay. No, I'm not. They're not happening.
Who, what?
For Kamala and Biden.
For Kamala. I'm not voting for Biden.
Or anybody. Well, but Mikey, what about anybody else? What about?
Wow. So he said that he's not voting for Biden, but he won't say that he's voting for Trump. Because if I say I'm voting for Trump, man, I might lose some jobs. I might lose some interviews. I might get beat up. Somebody might punch me in the stomach. Man, stop being some suckers, bro. If you like Trump, say you like Trump, man. Stop being gay about it. Okay, be gay. Ain't nothing wrong with being gay. I'm sorry for saying that. That's something I'm working on, saying that everything is gay. Okay, but if you support Trump, just say it. Like, what's the harm in saying you support Trump? What's the harm in that? Ain't no harm in that, bro. If you support Trump, don't sit there and say, well, I'm not voting for Biden. I'm not voting for Kamala. I'm not voting for none of them. I'm not voting for Don Lemon. I'm not voting. Going to name everybody that's on the left, but won't name nobody on the right that you are voting for.
No, Michael, listen, what about anybody
Vinny,
from
what
the
he's
left?
Saying is
who?
What he's saying
there's
is,
nobody.
I'm saying like
Kennedy.
What if Newsom or one of these cats pop up?
Gavin, I just left California. I'm not voting for Gavin with the good hair.
I love that. I love
Gavin
that.
With the good hair. Just like get out of here.
So my here's my thing though. So
I'm not a sucker.
Yeah, they love him. You see how much they love him, though.
They love his ass.
They like his hair.
But go deeper. Why do you say you're not a sucker? What does that mean?
Because I just moved out of Los Angeles.
Okay.
It's not happening.
Hey, Angel.
Explain that. For those of the people that have never lived in L.A., why the hell? You've been there for 20-plus years. Why the hell did you move out?
Well, I moved out because I wanted to go to New York. I didn't move out for any reason. I wanted to move back to New York full-time. That's why I left.
This is me, 1,000%. Alexander Smatrala, that's what I am. I'm that. This right here, what Alexander Smatrala said, I guess people should be pro their families. Future. That's me. And therefore, for peace and national prosperity. That's me. 1,000%. Anything that can prolong the Hall bloodline, and I hate to be selfish, but anything that can prolong the Hall bloodline, I'm all for it. Because I want to see my great-great-great-great-great-great-grandkids. And I want them to be able to tell the story of where they've come from. But the way it's looking, people are so selfish and power hungry, money thirsty, that they'll do anything. They're selling their souls for pennies on a dollar. They're pretty much trying to rearrange and reconstruct this country by bringing more people over who would listen to them and would do whatever they say just so they can receive some daggone some housing or a couple of dollars in their pockets. That's sad, man. They are literally creating new voters because the voters that they got are just problem children. Oh, they've been here too long. They're too entitled. They want their rights. They want rights, and they believe in the Constitution and all this other stuff. We're done with that. Let's bring other people over here from many other countries and just give them bare minimum and start this thing all over. Come on, let's start this thing all over. That's what we want to do. Come on, bro. It's trash. It's blatant disrespect and blatant disregard for the people who died for this country, man. It really is. It really is. And I'm not even a military person. When I was growing up, I thought that anybody that went to go fight for the military was wrong. That's what I thought. I thought it was wrong to go fight for the military because I thought that the country itself was bad. That's what I thought. I no longer think that, obviously, but I'm just saying that's what it's looking like. You look at places like New York, bruh. What's happening to New York right now? What? That's the city that everybody around the world want to go to. I watch international videos all the time where people walk up to other citizens in China or Korea or Japan or places in Africa or other countries, and they ask them, if you can go anywhere in the world, have you ever been to the U.S. before? And they'll be like, ooh, I want to go. I've never been. Where do you want to go in the U.S.? They always name the same thing. California and New York. New York City, California, Hollywood. But when we think about those places, come on, man. Those places are starting to look like trash, bro. No disrespect to New York. I'm not trying to disrespect New York. I'm just saying, based off of what we're allowing to happen with this whole sanctuary city stuff, bro, oh my gracious. Oh my gracious. It's almost blatant what they're trying to do, man. I don't like it.
But on top, the homelessness in Los Angeles and in California, San Diego,
look,
San Francisco. I could speak on those places. Sacramento,
yeah,
is so. But particularly in Los Angeles, in the Los Angeles area is unacceptable. It's scary. It's I don't know the how to fix it. It's unacceptable. It's not safe. It's not sanitary. I know California and Los Angeles is a driving city, but I do like to walk. When you walk, you shouldn't feel just uncomfortable by hordes and hordes and hordes of homeless people. It's not good for them. It ain't good for me. It's not good across the board.
It's not good across
the board. And the taxes suck, but the homelessness and how it went, you know, down so bad so quickly, and the crime.
Let's not forget about the crime.
Before we get into it, so last time on Tuesday, we announced anybody that buys the Future Looks Bright hats and the gear, and we said we want 1 million people wearing this gear during these strange times. We want people walking around saying, hey, I believe Future Looks Bright, and getting the reaction from other people when you wear that shirt. We have some stuff that we haven't...
Patrick Bet David is selling his product. I just want to put this one out here. Listen, this book right here is the very first link that you'll see in the descriptions, all right? It's my Amazon link. It's my Amazon affiliate link to this book right here, The Ass Backwards Way to Move Forward. It's by Celeste Duffy. I want you guys to go purchase this book, man. This is a lovely lady, very intelligent. This book is extremely intelligent. It's a great read. It's very smart. Anybody that's struggling with, I don't know, just getting your life together, getting your life in order. Like me, my life is not in order, man. Sometimes I'm so damn lazy. Sometimes I don't feel like doing a damn thing. When I know that there's work to be done in order for me to accomplish my goals, not only to accomplish my goals, but to pay my bills. And sometimes I need to kick myself in the butt. Like, Van, what are you doing? Wake up. Let's go. Let's get it. When it comes to working out or eating right, we all get there sometimes. We all feel like, okay, there's nothing else I can do. Like, I'm already over the hill. I'm already at this age. I'm already this. And we make up excuses not to move forward and not to be better. This book right here definitely helps. It will put that jolt back in you. Okay? Check it out. It's called The Ass Backwards Way to Move Forward. Go check it out, guys. I promise you, you're going to love it.